Before going on to derived monosaccharides, let's go on a quick recapitulation of carbohydrates. We know carbohydrates are compounds of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, basically carbon with water, carbon and water n times. This is the general formula for every carbohydrate. And carbohydrates can be small or large. Under large carbohydrates, we mainly talk about polysaccharides, and under small carbohydrates, we talk about monosaccharides, derived monosaccharides, and oligosaccharides. Monosaccharides are the simplest of all carbohydrates. They cannot be hydrolyzed further into simpler units because they are the simplest. And derived monosaccharides are nothing but some additional modified monosaccharides. So monosaccharides, they can be modified variously to form a number of different substances. And the important derivatives would be deoxy sugar, amino sugars, sugar acids, sugar alcohol. So deoxy sugar, from the name itself we can understand that there is some deoxygenation process involved. Now deoxygenation of ribose produces deoxyribose. So ribose undergoes deoxygenation and forms deoxyribose. The latter, this one, this is a constituent of nucleotide in DNA. We know that one nucleotide in DNA, DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid, and RNA stands for ribonucleic acid. So in ribose, which both are 5 carbon compounds, ribose is found in RNA and this is found in DNA. So one nucleotide in DNA, we know it will include a phosphate group. If we go from out to in, a phosphate group, then the deoxyribose and then the nitrogen base. So these three things together form one nucleotide in DNA. And if we talk about nucleoside, then we will not involve the phosphate group in case of nucleoside. But in nucleotide, we have these three components. So the sugar group in case of nucleotide of DNA has the deoxyribose, which is nothing but the deoxygenated form of ribose, which is a derived monosaccharide. So it's not a simple monosaccharide, rather it's a deoxy sugar, a derived monosaccharide. Okay, next thing is the amino sugars. Now, monosaccharides, they have an amino group, which is the NH2 group. In case of amino sugars, like glucosamine forms chitin, fungal cellulose, also hyaluronic acid, and also chondroitin sulfate. Let me write the names here. So, glucosamine forms chitin, fungal cellulose, hyaluronic acid, and chondroitin sulfate. So all these are examples of amino sugars. Let me highlight them. One is chitin, fungal cellulose, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate. So all these are amino sugars. That means they have this particular group in their monosaccharide structure. They have a monosaccharide structure, but along with them, this additional amino group they have variously. And galactosamine is also similarly a component of chondroitin sulfate. Okay. So glucosamine means glucose, which is the monosaccharide, plus an amino group. And galactosamine will be obviously galactose with an amino group, We have studied about these various monosaccharides, heptose, then hexose in our previous video. You can go and check these those out. Galactose, amine, similarly a component of chondroitin sulfate. Okay, then the third topic, which is sugar acids. Now ascorbic acid is a sugar acid, then glucuronic acid, then galacturonic acid, they are all sugar acids. And in fact the last two one which I said, glucuronic acid and galacturonic acid, they occur in mucopolysaccharides. Okay, so sugar acids, ascorbic acid, glucuronic acid, galacturonic acid, and the last two which I talked about, these two, they are occurring in mucopolysaccharides. Fine. Then comes sugar alcohol. So glycerol is involved, we know, in lipid synthesis, and also mannitol, which is a storage alcohol in some fruits and brown algae. They are also all examples of sugar alcohols. Now sugar, so monosaccharide already has hydroxyl parts in them. If you look at this particular structure of glucose, so many COH groups are there. Sorry. These are several COH groups. But in addition to these COH, means hydroxyl bonds, some extra alcohol groups are involved in case of sugar alcohols. And examples are mannitol, which is a storage alcohol in some fruits and brown algae. Okay, so let me highlight the important examples which I talked about in this video today. So first of all, we have the deoxyribose, then we have chitin, fungal cellulose, hyaluronic acid, chondroitin sulfate, this thing. Then we have ascorbic acid, then we have glucuronic acid, then we have galacturonic acid, and now mannitol. So this is all about derived monosaccharide. We have completed derived monosaccharides today. In the next class, we will discuss oligosaccharides. Till then, stay safe and like this video and subscribe our channel IV360. Thank you guys.